We weren't building the PC, but we worked with partners and we created tools to truly unlock the value of that tremendous capability. And that's now what we're doing for space.
A new era for space technology is emerging, and with it comes a universe of opportunities for partners to tap into. Welcome all to the Microsoft Partner Innovation Podcast. I'm your host, Jennifer Zarate. In this episode, we'll explore the world of Azure Space, a platform and partner ecosystem that together bridge the possibilities of space with the power of the cloud. Let's give a warm welcome to Steve Cate, Senior Director of Azure Space. Thank you for joining us today, Steve. How are you?
Thank you, Jennifer. It's great to be here with you.
Really do love it and excited for today's conversation. So jumping right on in and setting some groundwork here, you know, why is Microsoft getting involved in space and why now?
So it all starts with our purpose at Microsoft. Our mission is to empower every person and organization on the planet to achieve more. And we have productivity tools, and thousands of miles of fiber optic cable has been laid across the globe connected to massive data centers. Now, what's changing is that there are now thousands of satellites that are being launched into space. And it's not just the numbers, it's the new use cases, connectivity, Earth observation, and commercial scenarios that are unlocking massive amounts of data. In fact, space may be the world's largest untapped data lake. So why we're getting into this is bringing space and cloud computing technologies together to empower our customers.
Now, what would you say is the partner strategy here, right? You know, why is this an emerging space for partners?
So you won't see Microsoft rockets or Microsoft satellites in space. We're partnering with others who do that. And we're bringing cloud and space technologies together with an ecosystem. Now, it's also not just about working with space companies. There's actually an interesting study that was recently done by the Harvard Business Review. And what the title summed it up, that every company needs a space strategy now. And because it's the value of space data across agriculture, energy, sustainability, retail, these are the areas where we're working to help and partner.
So the takeaway, connectivity and digital resiliency being key, right?
Absolutely. So we're working on pillars in Azure Space of connect, analyze, and develop. And it's across a product family that we call Azure Orbital. Now, people may not realize, but every day they're actually using space. The blue dot on their phone is coming from a system called the Global Positioning System, or GPS. And what's changing is there's much more space systems in different areas, like you just talked about, connectivity and remote sensing, that will now be able to empower enterprises. So what does this mean for our customers? Well, it means more data. And it means more connectivity. And I'll give you a couple examples of partners that we're working with. So we're working on connecting anyone, anywhere through space into the cloud. And we're doing it through a multi-orbit, multi-vendor scenario. So we have resiliency. So one of our partners is SpaceX and their Starlink constellation. SES and their O3b mPOWER constellation, which will be launching to provide very high bandwidth capability. So an example where we worked with these partners is to enable the National Interagency Fire Center. And we helped work to provide connectivity to those firefighters that are in remote regions. So you can think of partners in the different use cases where they may need connectivity but don't have it today. And then it's getting space data and insights to them rapidly.
And that's fascinating to hear, really kind of seeing it full scale from our partnerships to how partners are then working to really support customers and right boots on the ground with these firefighters. That's amazing to hear. And so really kind of doubling down on the value prop to partners here, what are the different strategies that partners can take advantage of?
So we work with large companies like Airbus and small companies like Black Shark AI, which does a 3D digital twin of the Earth. And we support in a number of ways. So one of which is go-to-market. Microsoft has a very unique position in the industry where we're already empowering enterprises with our productivity suite. So what we're then doing is working with partners to ensure that their tools and capabilities combined with our tools can then support these customers. Now, it's also marketing. How do they get the word out there on their capabilities or benefiting from Microsoft's product suite and having incentives to leverage them and ensure that they are empowered to develop faster?
And that's fantastic to hear. So what's new for Azure Space that really brings the power of the cloud to partners and customers both on and off the planet?
So it's really exciting. So our work is not only on the ground, it's in space as well. And while we're not deploying Microsoft satellites, we are bringing our code and capabilities into space. And we recently announced a new product called the Azure Orbital Space Software Development Kit, SDK. And what we're working to do is enable any developer to be a space developer and develop and launch their code on orbit on spacecraft.
And as we start to wrap, you know, what would you say is the big picture vision for Azure Space? You know, what kind of impact or potential impact does this have across multiple industries?
The impact is huge, and we're working to democratize the benefits of space to make it more accessible. We believe that when technologies are accessible is really when the true innovation gets unlocked. And you can go back to our roots as a company. We weren't building the PC, but we worked with partners and we created tools to truly unlock the value of that tremendous capability. And that's now what we're doing for space.
Well, there you have it, folks. Interested in learning more, head over to Microsoft.com and look for Azure Space to really dive even deeper into some of what Steve and I talked about here today. Thank you, Steve, for your time. I had an absolute pleasure. Very cool to learn all about Azure Space. And of course, thank you to all of you for tuning in to another episode of the MPI Vodcast. I'm Jennifer Zarate.